I think we got it this time. Maybe not. Did it. That was, I like this combat, but damn. If I didn't go back through and kill all the little shit to get that extra level, I wouldn't have been able to do this, I don't think.
Do what you must, then we fly this foul place.
Yeah, okay.
Dead for good. Wow, the chosen of Merc. What a fight!
Ketherick's Netherstone. It's in his armor. Take it.
God damn it, Gale! You just had to wait for 5 fucking seconds. I don't even know how, like, the rest of us can even get up to you, bro. Damn, she got the hops.
The picture comes together. The Absolute is neither God nor man. It is the Elder Brain you saw, held here by those three against its will. The crown it wears controls it, and these stones control the crown. It has been dominated. To master an elder brain, to subdue it. Our enemies are formidable. The crown's markings suggest it was forged in Netherrealm, an ancient empire whose mastery over magic rivaled that of the gods. It is a crown.
Pretty sure Netherrealm is a nice one, though.
The stones were taken from its crest. They are netherstones, imbued with the ability to control the wearer of the crown. The crown's Netherese magic must be the true source of the parasite's abilities. This must be what elevates their potential. And it must be the reason nobody could heal you. If the crown can do this to the parasite, I dare not imagine what it is doing to the brain. One of them I know, Lord Enver Gortash, an arms dealer and a slaver, a worshipper of Bane, the god of tyranny. The other is a mystery to me, but the way she spoke, it is most likely she follows Baal, god of murder. Ketherick was a follower of Merkel, which means the Absolute is a front for the gods of death, and our enemies are the chosen of the dead three. Baal and Merkel, the tyrant, the assassin, and the necromancer. They are known to pick from their most devout followers, a chosen, granting them incredible powers. Each one alone would be a formidable enemy. But working together and controlling an elder brain, I dare not imagine what they might achieve. We prepare for the fight of our lives, and the lives of everyone in Faerun. The army of the Absolute is marching on Baldur's Gate. Within the city, an elder brain, brimming with power, ready to turn everyone within its reach into mind flayers. All it needs is an order the Death Gods Chosen are on the cusp of giving. We must wrest control of the brain from the Chosen before that happens. We must take their stones. Our chances of success are slim, but we must not fail. If we fail, everything ends. I will be your shield, but you must be the sword. And when the chance comes to strike, you must take it, for there may only be one chance.
Can't be moved against your will as well. Damn, we got some good shit. Alrighty, well, I'm going to end this recording session, take a small break. I'll probably come back in a little bit. So, yeah. Finally got past this mission. It was pretty good. The lore is pretty good. I enjoy all of Baldur's Gate, the actual setting. So to see, you know, the Illithids coming and that, like, all the campaign or the marketing campaign is showing the Illithids and stuff like that. Just for you to get to Act 2 and it's like, oh, it's all a front. It's actually the Dead Three. That's pretty good, because in Baldur's Gate, the Dead Three are very big. I know in Baldur's Gate, descend into Avernus, the Dead Three are the first people you deal with, pretty much. It's like the first dungeon. They're very big there. But yeah, I'll probably be back in a little bit to record some more. And I hope you all are enjoying the series. It's more laid back than other series I do, because, I don't know. I kind of want you to enjoy the story through my character's eyes. So, yeah.